domain, and range. We have already explained a function and how to check if a graph is a function. In this section, we are going to work with domain and range. Look at the picture. In simplest terms, the domain is all the x values that go into a function and range is all the y values that come out. Domain and range are very important in defining a function. Look at the graph again. The domain will be x values from here to this point. The range will be y values from here to up here. Let's have a look at range. The range of a function is the complete set of all possible resulting values of the dependent variable of a function after we have substituted the domain values, and y is usually the dependent variable. When finding the range, remember the following important points. Number one, we need to substitute different x values into the expression for y to see what is happening. Check if y is always positive, always negative, or maybe not equal to certain values. Number two, we need to make sure you look for minimum and maximum values of y. Number three, draw a sketch. In maths, it's very true that a picture is worth a thousand words, so a sketch is very important. To explain domain and range better, let us have a look at this example. In this example, we are given two sets. We have set A and set B. Look at this illustration. The set A is the domain. This is set A. Look at set B. The set of elements that get pointed to in B are the range. 5, 7, and 9 are actual values produced by the function. This is set B. So we can say our domain can be listed as 1, 2, and 3. And our range can be listed as 5, 7, and 9. Have a look at another example. In this example, we want to determine the domain of each of the following graphs. Look at all three graphs. Look at the x-axis, which is this horizontal line. All three graphs use all x values, meaning those that are negative and those that are positive. Let us use the first graph as an example. Look at the first graph. In this first graph, we see that positive x values are from here to the right. Negative x values are from here. Look at the graph. So, this graph uses all the positive x values. Let's look at the graph again. The graph uses negative x values from here to the left. Overall, we can say the graph uses all the x values, those that are positive and negative. All three graphs have the same domain. We write it like this. This domain means x can be any real number. Remember that a real number is a number that can be plotted on a number line. This domain means x is an element or member of real numbers. Remember, all of these graphs have the same domain. Look at our domain. This domain means x can be any real number. X is an element or member of real numbers. Let us have a look at another example. In this example, we want to determine the domain and range of each function. Let us go to the first graph. Let us find the domain of this graph. Look at the horizontal line. From here to here, we used all x values, those that are positive and those that are negative. So we can therefore say our domain will be x is an element of real numbers, which means x is any real number. Look at the domain. Please note that there is another way to write our domain. Look at this picture. The graph uses all the real x values, which means it uses values from negative infinity to positive infinity. We may write our domain like this. Let us now calculate the range of our graph. Look at the vertical line. From here to here, we use all the y values. We can therefore say our range will be y is an element of real numbers, which means y is any real number. Similarly, if we call positive y positive infinity and we call negative y negative infinity, then we can write our range as y is an element of negative infinity and positive infinity. We write it like this. Let us now go to the second graph. Let us determine the domain. Look at the graph. This graph uses x values from negative 2, which is here, to positive infinity, which is here at this x. So, our domain will be written like this. This minus 2 is not included. Look at the graph. The dot means minus 2 is not included. So our domain is x is an element of negative 2 and infinity. We write it like this. Let us now calculate the range. Look at the graph. This graph uses y values from 0, which is here, to positive infinity, which is here. Our range will be y is an element of 0 and infinity. We write it like this. Now that you have worked with domain and range, let us see if you can try the following activity.
The first one has been done for you.